Welcome to the new Drive. You may have noticed that in your Google Drive, it is asking on the top for you to try the new Drive. If you don't want to at this time, you can simply click the X. It will ask you over and over again. So if you don't want to do it now, that's fine, but it will ask you again. If you want to try it, you can take yourself to the new Google Drive. You will get some messages. For instance, welcome to the new Drive. Click once to select a file or folder, or double click to open it. So that's one of the bigger items, is double clicking it opens it now. Items can also be selected with arrow keys and opened with the enter key. Some other things. We can see more detailed information. So you are going to see this as well. This is all the recent activity that you've had. You can dismiss that or hide it by clicking the I button. And then everything shared with you appears in your incoming streams. So this is changed. Sometimes it's incoming, sometimes it's shared with me. Now it's going to be incoming. So once you have it, your Google Drive will be very similar to before. If you want to have a list view, you can do that. If you want a grid view, you can do that. You can also have some sorting options, which is the same as before, but now they have an A to Z. And then if you would like, you can actually leave the new Drive by clicking on this. One of the great features about this now is under the settings is you can download Drive. And what that will do is that will give you an option to have Google Drive as one of your choices, such as the U Drive or your C Drive. If there's any interest for that, please let us know as we're trying to gauge whether we want to incorporate this with our school laptops. So there you have it, the new Google Drive. If you need any further assistance, please ask.